Equity Market Update, August 2020. Indian equities continued to deliver positive returns month on month in August 2020, following its strong performance in the past 2 months. Nifty 50 was up by approximately 3%, supported by a rally in global markets, high global liquidity, improvement in sentiments, sequential improvement in economic activities across major countries, and better than expected Q1 FY21 results. This was partially offset by rise in border tension between India and China. The large caps underperformed mid caps and small caps significantly during the month. Amongst the sectoral performance, metal, banks, power, capital goods and auto were the best performing sectors, while IT, FMCG and oil and gas ended marginally negative for the month. Globally, most major indices also delivered positive returns during the month. FPIs were net buyers in August 2020, fourth month in a row, and bought equity worth $6.3 billion, a highest ever FPI inflow in a month. FPI flows have recovered strongly, and net inflows during the first 5 months of FY21 was approximately $11.2 billion, thus more than recouping the outflows of $8.3 billion seen in March 2020. Domestic equity-oriented mutual funds witnessed net outflows of ₹7,382 crore in July 2020, compared to net outflow of ₹2,673 crore a month ago. In the first 4 months of FY21, net outflows in domestic equity-oriented mutual fund schemes stood at approximately ₹1,130 crore. Out of the Q1 FY21 results declared, results of IT, cement, banks, power, construction and pharma were better than expectations, whereas oil and gas, consumer staples and auto were largely in line with expectations. Results of metal, industrials and logistics were below expectations. Outlook. As on 31st August 2020, Nifty 50 was trading at price-to-earnings multiple of 25.1x based on FY21 estimated earnings and 18.6x based on FY22 estimated earnings. While multiples are reasonable, especially given the low interest rate environment, in uncertain times like the current one, limited reliance can be placed on the price-to-earnings multiples for gauging valuations, as earnings are temporarily impacted, especially for FY21. In our opinion, the Indian market cap to GDP is a better indicator of valuation of the overall market in the current scenario. As of 31st August 2020, the Indian market capitalization stood at approximately 73% of GDP based on 2021 GDP, lower than its 10-year average. Also, it is worth noting that the gap between 10-year G-Sec and 1-year forward Nifty 50 earning yield is still below 10-year average. This further indicates that equity markets are attractively priced. Additionally, 10-year Nifty 50 returns of 7.7% CAGR have lagged nominal GDP growth of 12% CAGR for the last 10 years. Historically, periods where Nifty 50 returns have been below 10% CAGR for a 10-year period, it has been followed by good returns over the medium to long term. While the equity market has recovered significantly from lows seen in March 2020, the recovery is polarized, with top 5 stocks contributing a significant portion of the index movement. This shows that the broader market is still quite attractively valued and thus holds promise over the medium to long term, in our opinion. Aforesaid view is also supported by sequential recovery visible in the past few months and expectations that economic activity should normalize to a large extent in H2 FY21. Further, The government is aggressively pursuing a reform agenda and focusing on attracting investment, especially foreign investments, into manufacturing. Reforms in the agriculture and defense sector, push towards privatization of CPSEs, measures to incentivize manufacturing in India, etc., are few steps which are being taken in this direction. In view of the above, in our opinion, there is merit in increasing allocation to equities in a phased manner, or in staying invested as the case may be, for those with a medium to long-term view and in line with individual risk appetite. Significant rise in spread of COVID-19, unwinding of expansionary fiscal and monetary stimulus, sharp rise in crude oil prices, higher than expected NPAs post the moratorium, escalation of border tension between India and China, and or trade tension between US and China, etc., are key risks in the near term. Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Read all scheme-related documents carefully.